About a month ago, I asked you guys via my community tab to send me your photos to edit@iamrensi.com. And well, you guys did. So in today's video, I'm gonna edit your photos. If you're new to the channel, my name is Rens. I'm a digital artist from the Netherlands. And today's first submission is by Dave. He said, 3 pictures, 2 from Yellowstone National Park and 1 from the mountains of Tennessee. Surprise me with your editing if you choose my pics. Thank you very much for considering my photos, Dave. Thanks so much for submitting your beautiful photos, Dave. 3 photos for our first edit. Didn't really expect that, but I did my best to use all of them. I'm very excited for this first one, so let's jump straight into Affinity Photo. So, for this first edit, I started off with the background. I imported the first photo of the landscape and placed it right here at the bottom of the canvas with the Move tool. Awesome. Now, since the sky in this photo wasn't the most exciting, I planned on replacing it later. So I made a very simple selection of it using a selection brush tool, did some simple refinements and then masked it out. Alright, now that the sky was gone, it was time to drag in the second photo that David had sent us. I was thinking we could use that bump and the tree, mask it out and turn it into a huge floating rock ball. So once again I grabbed the selection brush tool, did some refining to get a better selection and masked everything out that I didn't need. Afterwards I manually fine-tuned the mask even further until I was really happy. Since I wanted my rock to become a sphere, I used the ellipse tool to create a circle as a reference. Simply hold shift when dragging to make a perfect circle. To create some space for our sphere, I dragged the background further down and then resized and repositioned it in the middle of our canvas. Next step, warp. I used the warp tool to align the rock with the circle, and that went way easier than I thought. Now, all that was left to do was to duplicate the half round rock without the tree onto a new layer and then rotate it. To make the rotation even easier, I moved the transform origin to around the middle of the ellipse to change its pivot point. That I did again, and there we had our sphere rock. To avoid making our sphere look cloned, I masked out some parts with a soft round brush so it would look more natural. Now it was time to give the sphere a bit more texture. To do so, I grouped all the rock layers together and used the group mask and the black brush to make it look more natural. Sweet. Alright, time to move on with the background. I used the inbuilt Affinity Photo stock panel to find a nice image of a sky, and this one I really liked, especially because of the lighting. So I used that, dragged it into place and used exposure to brighten it up a bit. To make this thing look more like an actual sphere, I had to add some depth. So I clipped another exposure adjustment layer to the rock, I darkened it a whole bunch and used the mask to add shadows, and created another exposure layer and brightened it up to paint in the highlights. This process is called dodging and burning. To create a bit more space for the sun, I squeezed in the background even further down. Now it was time to add photo number 3. At first I wasn't really sure how to use this photo, until I noticed the 3 girls sitting. Even though I wasn't really sure if they were related to you, Dave, I decided they would definitely add to the story of the edit, so I added them as well. So I grabbed the pen tool and separately cut out the girl in the pink shirt and the other 2 to be more flexible when positioning them. Hey, real quick, if you've been enjoying this video so far, don't forget to give it a like. And if you enjoy my content overall, make very sure to subscribe to the channel to never miss any future upload. And if you want to learn photo manipulation just like me, I've created a master course called The Art of Photo Manipulation, in which I'll teach you everything that I know about photo manipulation in Affinity Photo. If you're interested in this, check out the link down below in the description. Now let's get back into the video. To keep the rock in balance, I rotated the tree to the left side. I masked out the leg of the girl because I thought it was disturbing. Then with the brush tool I manually painted in some shadows to make it look like they were actually sitting. Since the sun is behind the sphere and pretty orange, I figured it wasn't a bad idea at all to add some orange highlights. For this I used the fill layer. Filled it with some light orange color and then used blend ranges, I inverted the layer mask to paint in the highlights with a soft round brush. I then repeated the same process, but instead of orange I used blue this time to paint in some reflections of the blue sky. Then I noticed the tree looked a bit strange, and that's because of the bed selection I made before. So to fix this I selected the layer with the tree and went to filters, colors and then remove white mud, and that improved it a lot. However, the branches got a little too dark overall, so to fix this, I painted in some highlights using the same orange fill layer that I used for the rock. Those little details add up to the overall end result, so that worked out great. Now we needed more highlights for the girls. For this, I created an extra light orange fill layer, used blend ranges to make it look more realistic, and then used the mask of the girls so it would only affect this layer. Then I painted back the effect on the inverted layer mask with a soft round brush. I slightly repositioned the pink girl, turned the sphere rock a little bit so that she could lean against the tree, and fix some other issues. Now, since the sun is very bright, I also added some light leak over the background. This I simply did by eyedropping a color from the background, creating a soft round blob, and then set the blend mode to screen and reshaped it with the move tool. Definitely a lot better than before. Then I added some shadows to the pink girl and the tree so it actually looked like the girl is leaning against the tree. To make things blend together even better, I added some more shadows to the girls, added some happy little birds, and painted in some rim lights to the sphere and the girls. Finally, I added the lens blur filter to create more depth, adjusted the colors just a little bit using an HSL adjustment layer, and added a vignette. And that's when I considered it done. Overall, I'm pretty happy with how it turned out, and that we managed to use all three photos. Thanks, David, for inspiring me to use your photos and create this fun image. I'll send it back to you as soon as I got the time.
I had a ton of fun editing Dave's photo, and if you want to get a chance of me editing your photo, submit your photo to edit@iamrensi.com. And don't forget to add your name, a short message, and optionally your social media handle for a shout out. Alright, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a like. And if you enjoyed this content overall, make very sure to subscribe to my channel. It would mean the world to me, and then I see you in my next video. Ciao!